Hello everyone, my name is Surendra and I'm from the AAA Tag Team in Cisco. Today I will be giving a brief explanation and overview of Network Access Work Center in ISE 2.1. Work centers are created for the ease of access to the administrators for common configurations on ISE. Network Access Center deals with the basic network access authentication such as MAB and Dot1x. This section also gives access to everything related to network access, starting from configuring the MAB and Dot1x policies to logging, troubleshooting the issues with MAB and Dot1x. Like all work centers, Network Access Center has also three non-visible categories, which are overview, configuration, and troubleshooting. Let us have a look at those sections. You can find the Network Access Work Center under Work Centers and Network Access. Once you navigate to the page, you will be landed on Overview section. It has two subsections, which are Introduction and Radius Live Log. Introduction gives you a brief overview of what network access is used to. Radius Live Log will give you access to the regular Radius Live Log, where you can monitor the authentications in live. The next section is the Identities, which basically gives you access to the endpoints, network access users, and identity source sequences. Under the endpoint section, you can clearly see all the details related to the endpoints that are connected to the network right now and are using Radius. And the network access users section will give you the access to the internal identity store of users. And the identity source sequences will let you configure and view the available identity source sequences on ISE. Next one is the ID groups. ID groups are the endpoint and user identity groups, which are present on ISE as of now. So if you look at the endpoint identity groups, we have Android, Apple device, Axis device, BlackBerry, Blacklist. So these are the endpoint identity groups that are already present on the ISE. You can either add one or you can modify it here. Same goes with the user identity groups. User identity groups also has predefined groups in it. If you want to add a group, you can add it. External identity sources. This is the regular external identity sources page where you'll be landed in configuration of certificate authentication profile, Active Directory, LDAP. ODBC and SAML ID providers are the new features that are included in ISE 2.1. The rest two are the same, Redis token and RSA secure ID. Here you can either make modifications or add new identity stores if you would like to. Under the network access resources, network devices is the section which gives you access to the list of devices that are configured on ISE. Those are the NAS devices. It gives you access to the default device configuration if you do not want to configure every device. And then external radio servers access, where you can view external radio servers if available, or you can add one. Radio server sequences, you can add a radio server sequence if you would like to, or modify if you want to. External MDM servers, where you can configure MDM servers and add them here. Next section is device groups. Under the device groups, you would see the device groups under which each network device is configured. You can either modify or add the existing device groups. If you want the device groups, you will see by default two groups, that is all device types and all locations. If you want, you can add new ones. Under the policy elements section in the Network Access Work Center, you would find two subsections, conditions and results. So under the conditions, you will have authentication conditions and authorization conditions that you can define or use the existing ones. There are two types of conditions for authentication. There is simple conditions and complex conditions. These are the regular items that we usually configure for MAB and Dot1x. Authorization simple conditions. This is also the regular authorization simple conditions that we use. And authorization compound conditions that we may want to use for wireless Dot1x, wired Dot1x, etc. And you can define time and date conditions over here. Under the results section, we can define either alert protocols for the authentication policy, authorization profiles, and DACLs, that is downloadable access lists for the authorization policies. As you can see, there are authorization profiles defined here. You can either modify them or add them here. And we can configure the downloadable access lists here. Under the policy sets, if policy sets are configured, you would see policy sets. If not, you will see a policy section where you can have authentication and authorization separately. As you can see, there are policy sets configured on this ISE node, where you can define both authentication and authorization policies at the same place. This ends the configuration part, and from here on, it will be the troubleshooting part. So the tools required for troubleshooting network access are provided here. That is Radius Authentication Troubleshooting, where you can provide the username and MAC address and run random tests to test the radius authentications. And there is endpoint debug section where you can enable debugs and check debugs for those endpoints from all over the logs in ISE. And then there's a TCP dump section to collect packet captures on ISE, where you can mention the ISE node and apply a filter if required and then collect a packet capture. And then there is collection filters, where you can apply a filter for radius authentications. Next section is the reports, where it's the regular reports from the operations tab. Here you can find the same thing, the reports. So it is given out here for ease of access. This is normal ISE reports where you can navigate to triplet diagnostics or radius authentications or whichever is required. The next section is the settings. So the settings tab will give us access to all the settings applicable to basic Dot1x and radius protocols. So the first one is client provisioning, where you can set the update feed URL for client provisioning. And then protocol section, where you can modify settings for EAPFast, generator pack for EAPFast, EAPTLS, EAP, radius. All these settings can be modified here. And then comes the collection filters. The collection filters, again, it is the same thing that was given in the troubleshoot section. And then comes the proxy settings. Under the proxy settings, you can define any proxy or server settings that you might have in your organization. Coming to the dictionaries part, dictionaries contain various attributes that are used in the authentication policies. Let us take an example of Active Directory dictionary, and you can see there are external groups and identity access restricted. These are the attributes that we usually use in the authorization policies. You can view the dictionaries over here. Those are the system defined dictionaries, and this is the user defined dictionaries. Here you can either add your own dictionary or just leave it blank. So that is the Network Access Center overview. Thanks for watching the video presentation. If you would like to be informed when new videos are added to the channel, please subscribe below. Thank you and have a great day.